So in 1943, when the government came in and took over the Hanford town site, which is where we're at right now, in its place, they built a construction camp known as the Hanford Construction Camp. The numbers associated with that are absolutely amazing. During the interview process alone, they interviewed over 225,000 candidates. That was to fill, and depending upon the sources, between 45,000 and 53,000 work positions out here. In order to house those people, you needed barracks, you needed trailers, and you needed all of the support structure to feed and house those workers.
Larry Denton, who worked at the B reactor as a reactor operator during the Manhattan Project, remembers the immense construction camp and the facilities needed to support the massive workforce at Hanford.
The construction camp was phenomenal as far as I was concerned. It housed 40,000 construction workers in barracks, another 10,000 in the trailer camp. They had no facilities really to take care of things like this, so they brought in railroad engines and parked them along the railroad track. The Milwaukee Railroad was extended down into the town of Hanford, and the barracks were heated by steam, and these railroad engines provided the steam for the heating of the camp. We had a hospital. I think it was a 60-room hospital. We had a big administration building, men's barracks and women's barracks. Women were segregated from the men in both cases, blacks and whites. And we had a grocery store. And like I said, we had that big rec hall. And we had some of the best orchestras in the world came in, entertained for us.